In this video, I'll show you how I implement the GTD workflow in Notion. This is a 5-steps productivity method from the book Getting Things Done. Capture, process, organize, review, and engage. The first step is capture. When we have a new idea, task, or project, the first step is to capture them. This helps free our brain for creative work and help us remember what we need to do. I use the button blocks to help me quickly add a new task, project, or reference. This makes it easy to click on even when I'm on my phone. The next step is process. We'll head over to our inbox page and process our previously captured item. We first ask whether the captured task is actionable. If it is a non-action item, you can eliminate it or save it as a reference by dragging and dropping under the reference database. If it's actionable, but it takes less than 2 minutes, do it now and check it off. If it takes longer than that, we then ask what is the next action. If there are maybe 1 to 2 steps before, we can add subtasks below it. There are multiple steps and that these tasks require an extended period of time to complete. It can be turned into a project by dragging and dropping under the project's database. Tasks can be organized into projects, deadlines, and contexts. If the task belongs to a project, we can assign it to the respective project. And opening a project page, we'll be able to see all the relevant tasks and add new ones from there. Once we process and organize the task, we can mark it as a next action to remove it from the inbox view. Context can be a location, an action, or an item. It can be anything that helps you batch similar tasks. If I need to buy eggs, I will give it a grocery context and turn it into a next action. Similarly for buy avocados, I will give the same context and turn it into a next action. The next time I visit the grocery store, I can filter for the context groceries to see everything I need to get from the store. The next step is review. A weekly review is what keeps your system free from chaos and keeping only what is relevant to you. Firstly, we want to get clear. Think back on your past week and see if there's anything you have missed. These items will go into your inbox view and you can process them on the spot along with other items still in your inbox. Secondly, we want to get current. We want to keep ourselves updated on the things that are still on our next action list or deadlines and events that are coming up. On top of that, we also want to know the current projects that we are working on and the reference we have yet to review. Lastly, it's time to get creative. This is where we review our some day list and decide if there are any next action or projects we want to move forward. If we have any new and big ideas, this is also the place and time to put it down. The final step in the GTD workflow is engage. No matter how organized you are, at the end of the day, you need to do the work to get things done. Use the respective pages as you go about your day and start checking off your tasks and move your projects forward. I hope you found this video helpful, and if you'd like to implement the GTD workflow, check out my Notion template in the description below. Fearless.